Hello and welcome to a new video. So today I'm going to show you how to set up n8n with docker-compose. So n8n is this software which is a very popular automation tool, and it works mostly with a graphical web interface. So let's see the documentation for docker-compose, but we're not going to follow verbatim this page because I tried it and it didn't work because it's quite complex. So I tried to simplify it a lot. And if you see here, install Docker Compose. This is the usual stuff. The non-root user access, okay. Yeah, okay, and then there is the DNS setup. But I skipped this because I just wanted to test n8n very quickly without doing any special setup. So like I do with all the other Docker containers. Okay, then there is the env file, okay. But we're not going to use that either. Okay, this one we need to do it. So we need to create a local files directory, which is then going to be used as a volume here. Okay, and then instead of using this anonymous volume, I think it is, okay, called n8n data, then it's binded here. We're going to use a local volume like we did with local files. And all this, this other service traffic, we're not going to use it. And so we're not going to use all these labels as well. And this part is more or less the same. Now I'm going to show you. Okay, so this is this was my test environment. Now I reloaded the page, so of course the server wasn't running. Anyways, this is the full Docker Compose I was using to test it. So okay, we still have the image, which is the same. The ports, since I'm running it in a virtual machine, I set to listen for every address. So instead of a local host, there is 0000. And then since the IP of my machine is this one here, 192.168.0.70, I'm using that as an n8n host. The webhook URL has the same IP, and then the port 5678, like the one used here. And then you also need to add this environment variable, because otherwise you will not be able to access it with plain HTTP. So this one is required. Then, as I said, there are the two volumes. Now let's see. So as I said, we need to create, and it's also written here. Yeah, if you see here, mkd local files. Okay. And then we need also to create this one here. So mkd n8n data, but we need to change its owner to the user and group 1000, otherwise the Docker container will not have enough permissions to operate on this directory. So it's very simple, you just do like this, so 1000 and 1000, sorry, we need sudo. Okay, so now we have the three, the file and the two directories. So what you do next is just docker compose up. Okay. It should work. Yeah, okay, it's doing the database migration steps because it uses, I noticed it uses SQLite. Okay. So see here, we now have our listening address. Okay, let's see what happens. Okay, we the first thing you get is this page where you need to set up the admin or the owner account. Okay, you don't have to use a real email. I'm going to show you what happens. Okay, and then 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 A. So 1 2 3 4 5 7 8 A. I don't want to receive. Next. Okay, this one, we don't really care about this form, get started. We don't care about the free license. And here you have it. Now you can create your workflows. Of course, this is not a production ready environment. It's just for testing because I didn't want to spend all the time creating the DNS setup and creating a domain just for this, but maybe in the future. Yeah, I'm going to show you when you import from a file, because I tested a couple of automations, even if they don't do anything at the moment. So here I imported here from import from file, and it's a JSON file, and yeah, you can do your stuff. Okay, see what happens. We we have our form, because this is a form node test, put the today's date, submit, and so here you have your result, and so it works. Okay, so this wasn't too hard, like this, and yeah, if you like the video, as usual, put a thumbs up and subscribe, and as always, bye-bye.